In 1959, rock and roll had died. Buddy Holly, the Big Bopper, and Richie Valens were all in a plane crash. James Dean and his iconic red jacket were gone in a car accident. And Elvis was soon to be drafted.
At Camp Chef, the king of rock and roll will be keeping time to non-hip bugle calls. Tired, the gyrating guitarist's departure from the public eye left his blue jean fans all shook up, so we hear.
But then again, in 1963, rock and roll was resurrected, but this time, it had a British accent. It was a music revolution full of youthful energy and teen spirit. The British invasion was headed by the sound of the Mercy Beat. This music was the second era of rock and roll. Large, urban English cities like Liverpool, Birmingham, and Manchester were at the foreground of the Mercy Beat scene, with a number of influential bands emanating from each city, including The Searchers, The Hollies, Jerry and the Pacemakers, Herman's Hermits, Freddie and the Dreamers, The Kinks, The Mindbenders, and The Swinging Blue Jeans. The British invasion captured a magical time. This music was topping the radio charts in Britain and stateside in America. The swinging 60s became a time that celebrated British music, film, and fashion. The vibration was carried across the Atlantic Ocean and rocked the USA from 1964 to 1969. Time magazine epitomized swinging London on their cover, and a chain reaction of everything British became the rage.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is London. Swinging London, it's been called, though some people might find a different adjective. Social rebels have taken over in what seems more like an invasion than a revolution, because they've got their own new language that is way out and weird.
Hymnlines across the nation rose high up the legs of teenage girls who wore Mary Quant miniskirts. Girls made up their eyes with liner and mascara to create big saucer-like orbs. They cut their hair short and tried to be the spitting image of the first ever supermodel, Twiggy. American girls craved the British Dolly Bird look so much that teen magazines offered pop stars' girlfriends regular fashion columns in their magazine. The boys dressed in collarless jackets with skinny ties and boots with Cuban heels. Trousers were cut tight at the ankle, uncuffed with no pockets, and were called drainies because they resembled drain pipes. Edwardian coats with velvet lapels, ruffled shirts, and shaggy haircuts with a fringe across the forehead were a very fashionable look. Every young man wanted to be a mod. Carnaby Street was the place to buy your clothes in England, and soon in the USA, small boutiques popped up with names like Paraphernalia, Youthquake, Pop, and Granny Takes a Trip. Fashion was the first effect of the British invasion. Along with the British invasion came a string of British actors, directors, and landmark films. Actors like Julie Christie, Lawrence Harvey, and Peter O'Toole monopolized the Oscar awards. Films like Darling, Blow Up,
and the hair back, and the hair back. Come on, that's great, that's good.
Tom Jones, Hard Day's Night, Lawrence of Arabia, Lion in Winter, and the prime of Miss Jean Brody dominated the movie theater box offices. Directors Richard Lester and Tony Richardson had changed the style of directing. Just as it took a year or so for the British bands to come across the Atlantic, the same went for a new British film hero. The same conviction, self-assurance, and humor which permeated the Mercy Beat sound could also be found in James Bond.
James Bond.
Mr. Bond.
Films like Dr. No, From Russia With Love, and others were huge box office successes. The Bond films were a projection of British life, including bowler hats and Aston Martin sports cars, and inspired American shows like the very popular Man from U.N.C.L.E. with British heartthrob David McCallum.
U.N.C.L.E. is an organization consisting of agents of all nationalities.
It's involved in maintaining political and legal order anywhere in the world.
The most obvious thing for American bands to do was imitate the British sound in order to succeed. The beat sound was not that hard to copy. The Bo Brummels from San Francisco broke the charts with their mod look and their shaggy haircuts, having three of the top 20 singles in 1965. The American Breed song, Bend Me, Shape Me, reached number 5 in 1967. In 1968, America had turned pop music into a bubblegum sound with the Monkees.
Oh, I could hide neath the wing of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm.
And Paul Revere and the Raiders. A new sound had emerged from California with the Byrds.
A time to reap, a time to heal, a time to heal.
And the Mamas and Papas.
To me. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be.
But when the Beatles released Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band in the summer of 1967, a new sound emerged from England.
Good evening. The pot and psychedelic cult, whatever else it may be, is new and different. Unlike the nihilist beatniks of a few years back, today's LSD cultists say that they are turned on, not turned off. And if they talk of dropping out, they do so because they reject square society and claim they can build a better one.
Sgt. Pepper's had turned pop music into an art form by adding a touch of psychedelia. New British bands like Cream, Deep Purple, Led Zeppelin, and Pink Floyd were selling out concert venues in both America and the United States. The second era of rock and roll, the British Invasion, dominated the 60s. What begins with girls tossing away their hairspray and boys growing their hair long paved the way for personal freedoms of blacks, gays, and women. More than anything, the British Invasion helped to show Americans aspects of their own musical heritage that they had not noticed. Sometimes it takes an outsider to show you the obvious. The swinging 60s was a decade of rapid change, an age of rebellion, and made great strides in music, fashion, and the arts. The mods, the music, and the art not only brought changes to England, but brought a whole new climate of change throughout the world. The swinging 60s was a phenomenon caused by a youthquake of England's teens, who were full of hope and optimism for a better future.